How to compare two stored procedures in two different SQL Server databases? That's a pretty simple but very popular question. Basically, there are two major options here. The first option is to use Transact-SQL to extract stored procedure code and then use any TextDiff tool to compare that code. The second option is to use any schema comparison tool for SQL Server. And now let's switch to the demo. Here we have SQL Server Management Studio connected to one of the local servers. We have several AdventureWorks databases here. Let's compare one of the stored procedures. Expand the database. Programmability. Stored procedures, and let's compare the first one. Open a new query and type select object underscore definition from object underscore ID quotes and drag the procedure name from the object tree. Execute. Let's copy the result and paste it into the TextDiff tool, in our case, WinMerge, but you can use any other tool. We see that there is something wrong with line breaks. To fix this, let's change select with a print. Press F5 to execute, and now we see that line breaks are fixed. Select text. Copy. Paste to WinMerge. Now let's change the database and run the same. Select. Copy. Paste. Click Refresh Diff, and we see there is one difference. Jump to that difference, and we see we have inner join on the left and left join on the right. In many database clients, particularly in Management Studio, you can obtain the text of the stored procedure even without typing any SQL. Just right-click on the procedure name and then modify, or you can use one of the script stored procedure as commands. Now let's compare stored procedures using the database comparison tool. We will use the free version of MssqlMerge, which allows us to compare both schema and data. This tool also has a pro version with a number of enhancements, but for our task, the free version is enough. Connect to our databases. Open the list of changed stored procedures and click on the procedure name to compare its definition. Here we can see the same change, inner join on the left and left join on the right. As we can see, using the database diff tool can significantly simplify our task. We can filter to show only changed procedures and compare each of them with just a single click. And if we decide that we need to synchronize these changes, this can be done with just a couple more clicks. Let's talk briefly about cases where our solution may not work properly. The first issue is permissions. If our database user lacks sufficient permissions to retrieve procedure definitions from the database, then there is nothing we can do about it. It does not matter if we use any tool or an object definition function. The next issue is when the stored procedure is created using the with encryption option. The result is similar to missing permissions. Object definition returns null, and MssqlMerge shows such objects as grayed out, without the ability to compare or synchronize stored procedures. Next, the procedure could be renamed using sp-rename. In this case, the object definition function still returns the original create procedure statement with the old name. If we compare such text with another database, this can produce just one more changed line of code. MssqlMerge takes care of this and shows the proper object name even if the procedure was renamed. The last potential issue is the trailing semicolon in the stored procedure text. It is a Transact-SQL statement delimiter. And depending on how the stored procedure was created or altered, the object definition function may or may not return the trailing semicolon. This is just a minor issue we need to keep in mind, and MssqlMerge Pro has an option to always trim the trailing semicolon to avoid this issue. That's all. Thanks for watching.